Bellbrook Sugar Creek school officials unveiled and approved another round of budget cuts.
And they say more will be required if the voters reject a 5.7 mil levy in March. 2 News reporter Kristen Escow breaks down those additional cuts that are possible tonight here on your local election headquarters.
The school board giving the green light for nearly $750,000 in cuts, regardless of whether or not next month's levy passes. School officials announced tonight if it fails, another $2.4 million in cuts would be needed.
You have to decide what kind of school district do you want. Do you want a state minimum kind of school district? Or do you want some that have some opportunities for our students?
The announced budget cuts come on the heels of a state performance audit, which found the district's deficit could grow to $11 million in 2023 if no new levies are passed. The 5.7 mil continuous levy on the ballot next month would generate $3.3 million annually and cost taxpayers about $200 per year per $100,000 in appraised property value. This comes after a levy failed last May. At a school board meeting Thursday, the board approved a new round of cuts on top of the $2.3 million in budget reductions already made since summer 2018. Those cuts include all middle school world language offerings and one high school English position. Pay-to-play fees for sports are increasing from $150 to $200, and all-day kindergarten tuition is set to increase by $900 per year. But if the levy fails next month, the superintendent has proposed another round of multiple budget cuts. Those include all high school busing and reduced busing for middle and intermediate school students. A high school social studies teacher would also be cut, along with 85 paid supplemental positions throughout the district, like coaches and club advisors. All STEM and art classes would be cut at the elementary and intermediate schools, and library positions would be reduced throughout the district. Pay-to-play fees would increase again by $100. Several people from both sides of the levy issue spoke during the public comments period. Meanwhile, several school board members directed their frustration at the state's school funding system.
Our state representatives, state senators, need to know how you feel, and they need to know what they need to do to finance schools.
The superintendent didn't rule out any other possible cuts, levies, or other changes to the district's finances in years to come. In Sugar Creek Township, Kristen Escow, 2 News, working for you.